Italians say, l'Italia è la culla del bel canto. Italy is the cradle of beautiful singing. It's the birthplace of opera, a land of music lovers and music makers.
There is nobody in this country who is not trying to sing. Especially if he has a tenor voice.
Luciano Pavarotti performs today in the grand tradition of the Italian tenor, the tradition of Di Stefano, Gigli, Scipa. The grand tradition redefined at the beginning of the 20th century by the exceptional voice and personal appeal of Enrico Caruso.
I think Caruso for the singer means the base of the building. It doesn't matter how tall is the building, how heavy is going to be the building, on the basement of Caruso it will always rest, because it's essential, because vocally is enormous, and is very, very, very close to the true in expression. I think my first teacher in terms of inspiring me, trying to sing even when I was a kid, I think they were all the tenor of the past, the record of all the tenor of the past.
In the 1700s, there was the bel canto style, and generally they were light tenors. Tenors with large voices, lirico or lirico spinto, came about toward the end of the 19th century. Caruso's revolution came really as a reaction to the bel canto style. Not that Caruso had intended it, but he was born with an extraordinary tenor voice with some of the qualities of a baritone. He delivered a final blow to that period of singing primarily for technical display. In Caruso's voice, we heard genuine human inflections, a person's voice, not just a singer's voice. A true, real voice. Luciano sings this piece exactly as written, while a bel canto singer would sing it. With a lot of variations and flourishes that are completely different from the vocal style of Luciano and that of Caruso. So bel canto is more elaborate, lirico more human, truer.
The repertory in our program is closely identified with the tradition of Italian tenors and includes music reaching back into the 18th century. songs exploring love, beginning with Paisiello's playful love song from his comic opera La Molinara, The Maid of the Mill.
Nel cor più non mi sento brillare la gioventù, cagion del mio tormento, amor sei colpa tu. Mi pizzichi, mi stuzzichi, mi pungichi, mi mastichi, che cos'è questo in me? Pietà, 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 amore un certo che disperarmi fa. Mi pizzichi, mi stuzzichi, mi pungichi, mi mastichi, che cos'è questo in me? Pietà, 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 amore un certo che disperarmi fa.
We can still hear the vocal flourishes of the bel canto in Donizetti's song, celebrating the love of the sea and the sailor's life.
Voga, voga, il vento tace, pure l'onda e ciel sereno, solo un alito di pace, pare che allegri e cielo e mar. Voga, voga, marinar, voga, voga, marinar. Or che tutto a noi sorride in si tenero momento, all'ebbrezza del contento voglio l'arme abbandonar. Voga, voga, marinar, o marinar. Voga, voga, il vento tace, pure l'onda del cielo sereno, ed un alito di pace par che allegri e cielo e mar. Che sei fiero la tempesta, ambidue ne tragge a morte, ambidue ne tragge a morte. Sarà lieta la mia sorte, al tuo fianco io vo' spirar, sì, al tuo fianco io vo' spirar. Voga, voga, o marinar, voga, voga, o marinar, sarà lieta la mia sorte, al tuo fianco io vo' spirar. Voga, voga, marinar, voga, voga, marinar, o marinar, o marinar.
Pavarotti è nato nella...
Pavarotti was born into the right family. His father was a tenor, and Luciano quickly followed him into the Rossini Chorale. There's an extreme passion for music in this region. You have clubs for singing, societies, they breathe music from childhood. Growing up with music was very important for him.
In a choral, there is always the old people. Then when they see a young kid come in, they always think that he's an idiot. Then he cannot sing. He cannot sing appropriately. He cannot do a certain thing different than what they always have done.
Che belle visini che laga.
Oi lì, oi là, mi fa innamorare.
But then, if you prove to be very good, you become one of them.
Poi andiamo avanti. Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Le dolcezze dell'amore insieme. Via.
Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Le dolcezze dell'amore.
Adesso cerchiamo di fare tutto staccato, tranne valore. Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Le dolcezze dell'amore.
Sarà un premio al tuo valore. Sarà un premio al tuo valore.
Le dolcezze dell'amor, sì, dell'amor. Le dolcezze dell'amor, sì, dell'amor.
I have a big respect for these people. They do this not for profession, but they do very seriously. They work. And every night, instead to go out, they go to sing.
Sarà un premio al tuo valore, tu dici via.
Sarà un premio al tuo valore, sarà un premio al tuo valore.
Le dolcezze dell'amore.
Benissimo.
Dell'amore.
Adesso questo non è facile, rifacciamo con la fermata in mezzo.
Sarà un premio al tuo valore, sarà un premio al tuo valore.
It's exactly 35 years I've been a member of the chorus. A long time, like many of us. My father was a member and had a very beautiful voice. Like mine, let's say. I began listening to opera on the radio after the Second World War. I started singing in church and then I joined the Rossini Chorale.
Le dolcezze dell'amor, sì, dell'amor. Le dolcezze dell'amor, sì, dell'amor.
Va bene, il finale non importa.
I think that for man, the first form of artistic expression was really singing. Because if we go all the way back, when man was still a form of ape, it seems to me that when he had some kind of victory, captured an animal for his dinner, let's say, he would let out cries of exhilaration.
Luciano da giovane.
Luciano always had a very beautiful voice, subtle, high. His father, Fernando Pavarotti, had a voice just as beautiful. He was the greatest tenor that I've ever heard, an exceptional voice. In 1957, Fernando Pavarotti sang La Giana in Cork. I remember the incredible high notes. The maestro gave us the pitch for La Giana. I took it even higher. It was Gilli with a little more fat.
Grande tenor Fernando.
Must have hit 3,000 high C's, right, Fernando? An Irish newspaper ran the headline, Fernando is a world-class tenor. He would have been a great opera singer if he had studied.
A voice alone is not enough. For example, he did not have ambition, he did not have courage to go in front of the audience face to face and say, here I am a tenor, I would like to sing, I want to sing, that my father was unable to say. I think I was a little like him at the beginning, but Paula, who was a tenor already, he really gave me the pushing with example. And every day, I remember for 6 months, consecutive months, I just make vocalize, E-U-O-I, and nothing other than that, just to open this joy, because I was a little close. I remember very well. Every time he was, for example, explaining the cover sound, the suoni di passaggio, I always try, and of course I crack, and I say, I cannot do it. And he says, listen. And he makes the sound, and he says, if I do this, then I am a person, you can do this, you are an animal. I always remember that. Of course, he was joking, because very, very sweet man.
Proprio dare una rotondità un pochino di più.
And after 6 months, we make a little baroque song, and then little by little, I begin to study operatic pieces.
Just make a nice diminuendo, and what follows will be more brilliant.
Bravo Codò, eri pensiero, eri pensiero.
Luciano went on studying and became the great Luciano Pavarotti, the envy of the world.
O Colombina is generally sung by tenorino, but once more, Caruso changed his attitude and he sang in full voice. And so, since then, some other tenor have tried to do it in full voice, even in concert.
Chiamando e sospirando aspetta il poverino. La tua faccetta mostrami ch'io vo baciare, se ne sa parader. La tua boccuccia, amor mi cruccia, amor mi cruccia e mi sta tormentar, e mi sta tormentar. Oh, colombina, schiudimi il finestrino che a te vicino, di te chiamando e sospirando è il povero Arlecchino. A te vicino, Arlecchino.
I think the father saw the son become what he himself wanted to be, but was never able to be.
Guest tenors Luciano and Fernando Pavarotti join the Rossini chorale in a traditional love song of their native city, Modena.
It's one question, but you must have musicality, you must have rhythmicality, intelligence, memory. To make a complete artist, you have so many, many, many things together, you make a great singer. But if you have, we have one big example, the voice is not everything. We have Tito Skipa with a feeling, want a small voice, he become great, like a Caruso.
The voice is not big, it's particular. After two words, you understand who is. And that is very, very, very important, because you have no doubt. And you are following one person with a personality. Tell you one thing. Every time I'm studying a new piece, I always bring around me all the tape of the most important tenor of the past and even of the present, just to know what is going on in the piece, because the time to study a month or two one song, we don't have anymore. Skipa is unsurpassed.
La vita triste senza amore, tutto svanisce e nulla mi sorride più. Ho una speranza ancora in fondo al cuore, questa speranza mia sei solo tu. Tornerà vicino a me.
Just to understand the phrasing and the way in which he says the word, with absolutely master, forever.
Fra le sue braccia amore, egli ti stringerà, la ninna nanna ancora ti canterà. Sei tutta la mia vita, tutto tu sei per me, la gioia più infinita mi viene sol da te, mio bene. Torna piccina mia, torna che il tuo papà, la ninna nanna ancora ti canterà.
Yeah, you sang with all the great ones, Fernando. Now take Pertile and Gili. One did Bello and Mascara, and the other one did La Gioconda.
Oh.
prego. Gigli. Beniamino Gigli. It was in Modena, I was 12, I remember vividly. And I did like the performance, good, but not. And then, at the end of the opera, they brought a piano on the stage. And Gigli make a concert, on request. Di quella pira, okay, di quella pira. Nessun dono. Una furtiva. Doesn't matter what he sang. I think he sang something like 20 or 30 pieces after the opera. At that point, I realized that this is the most elastic, the most vocal of all the tenor.
Gigli was a fascinating tenor. Campo Galliani used to say that he had the voice of a woman, which is a strange way to put it. I think, rather, that he had the voice of a lily, a flower, very gentle. But he was, without a doubt, a very important tenor because of his long career, his technical mastery, and his legato. I think Luciano took the legato from Gigli. Legato means sustaining the sung note with the same vibrancy until the very end.
Anche per noi l'onorevole Andreotti stringe la mano a Gigli.
Donaudi consciously imitates the melodic style of the 18th century, but uses 20th century harmonies in this song, expressing the exquisite pain of love lost.
Giorno mi
darmi ad aletra cura. Sol mi tormenta un pensiero, ma senza lei che farò? Mi par così
This is Giuseppe Di Stefano, and this is the tenor who made me fight with my father. Because when he came out, I say to him, "Papa, I like this more. I don't want to take Gigli in less consideration." My father was a super fanatic of Gigli, but I like this young man more because he's giving me a new message. With a beautiful voice, he's going to try to stay close to the truth. And he makes open sound and they excite me. With this kind of pronunciation, then I would like to say sexual, not even sexy, sexual, really beautiful.
Di Stefano had the exceptional interpretive skills of a great creative artist, and I believe Luciano learned a lot from him. But he is shrewd enough not to follow his technical path. because Di Stefano's technique was not good. Not good because, to put it technically, he used to open the notes of the passaggio when they need to be more focused. The passaggio are the notes between the mid and high range, where the tenor needs to sing the vowels a little darker. Di Stefano sings a little bit. A classical tenor sings rounder and softer and tires the voice less.
Opera permeates the musical life of Modena, from its opera house to the local music school where Pavarotti's teacher once studied.
The piece by Giacomo Puccini was chosen for the children to bring them closer to the world of opera. So it's really a lesson within a lesson.
No. La virgola sui monti delle lunga, ancora.
Puccini's best-loved opera, La Bohème, had its beginning, according to the composer himself, in this love song, which he submitted to the musical arts magazine, Paganini.
Il sole allegramente batte ai tuoi vetri. Amore, pian pian batte la tuo cuore, e l'uno e l'altro chiama. Il sole dice, odormente, mostrati che sei bella. Sorella, col tuo primo pensiero, pensa chi t'ama, pensa chi t'ama.
After his debut, a singer usually begins to tour the world and encounters all musical styles. Certainly it helps an artist to work with conductors like von Karajan, Kleiber, Abbado, Muti.
Thank you.
Devo dire una cosa che non
I have to say something that's not said very often about Luciano, but Luciano doesn't read music at all.
Per cui, quando studia,
so when he studies, he absorbs by listening. Then the music ripens internally. This inability to read music is something famous conductors used to speak to me about. They'd say, it's better if a singer can't read the music. He uses his imagination more freely. Luciano's vocal style brings many components into a miraculous equilibrium. He has absorbed the expressivity of Caruso, Di Stefano's artistic force, still with a very strong technique. For Luciano, text is very important. It has to be for a singer, as for an actor, to think of the meaning of each word. If one says amore, love, one has to say it in a certain way, thinking of the meaning of the word. Luciano always studies the text very seriously.
Non t'amo più of Tosti is a song translated from Italian to English as I don't love you anymore. You are no more my dream. There is a suspect that saying something like that, she is still your dream. But probably not.
I'm not sure.